guys, what's going on? It's Mad Mobile King Clutch here. End the day, guys. We are back on the MLB The Show 17. We're on the road to the show, guys. Now, today, right now, we're batting fourth, which is very surprising. They had me as a shortstop batting in fourth. But today, guys, this episode's going to be very long. It's going to be like a 20-minute long episode. But today, there's something I want to talk to you guys about. Now, I know my beds are wrecked. I'm dead. I'm not bed, sorry. But as I was saying, with the whole, with these, they're kind of hard to talk about. So I decided some of them I'll talk to you guys about the gameplay. Some of them I'll ramble on randomly. And some of them I'll have a set topic like I want to do in this one. So, guys, today we're playing the freaking Rubber Ducks again. You guys saw my last rant on the freaking Rubber Ducks in like two episodes ago, I think. Two episodes. I don't know when that's going to go up. I have no idea when these are going to go up. So don't really ask, because I don't know, guys. But anyways, today, guys, we're going to be talking about french fries. You guys know what french fries are. They're like potatoes, so they're technically a vegetable, so you can eat as many as you want and still be healthy and say you eat vegetables. Right, guys? Just kidding. I don't think it works. But you guys know french fries, they're made from potatoes. Potatoes are great. I love potatoes. I love baked potatoes, mashed potatoes, french fries. I like potatoes in general.
Yeah, you don't really. It's like 16.
They honestly really don't taste like much. They're just kind of, you know, fluffy. But we're going to talk about french fries, guys. So you guys probably were wondering, why french fries?
How big are
those? I really don't know. I just kind of like french fries. And there's a lot of french fries. Like, there's lots of different french fries, and honestly, french fries are probably one of my favorite foods. I actually I like any food pretty much. There's not really a food I don't like. But anyways, guys, so with french fries, you can dip french fries in pretty much anything. Most people dip them in either ketchup. Most people dip them in ketchup. Some people dip them in ranch or whatever else they feel like it. But anyways, ranch and ketchup are the... I usually eat them in ranch, to be honest. But they taste fine in ketchup, too. But anyways, with french fries, you know, you can get, like... You can go to, like, Red Robin. If you guys don't know what Red Robin is, it's just a burger place. You know, you can... They have, like, those big steak fries that are, like, you know, like, that big. They're, like, big fries. Like, they're thick. Or you can go to, like... if you guys don't know what Steak and Shake is, it's pretty much the same thing as Red Robin, except it's a little bit cheaper. They're really fast there and everything. You know, it's like, it's a sit-down restaurant, but it's fast. They have that, and then there's like Five Guys, which we don't, in Michigan, we don't have In-N-Out or Whataburger or like any of those places, so I'm not going to include those. But, like, you know, then you got McDonald's, which is just, like, those are like the in-between ones. And like Steak and Shake french fries, they're very skinny. They're like literally like the size of my pinky or smaller. They're very small. Like, they're not thick. They're not like big steak fries. They're just skinny, small french fries. So, I mean, like, you got tons of versions of french fries. Like, literally, you could go on and on and on and on and on. There's so many freaking different kinds of french fries. But really, I don't really care. As long as they taste fine, then you got sweet potato fries. You got waffle fries from Chick-fil-A. We really don't have any Chick-fil-A's in Michigan. We have like two. But they're both like an hour away from where I live, which is like the second biggest city in the state, which I don't understand. But then we do get a base hit. But I mean, like, there's so many different versions of french fries. And like, most people, like, I've seen some people eat like lots of french fries, and Five Guys has good food. We hard to go there. But yeah, so like, there's literally so many kinds of french fries. Like, they're pretty good in ketchup too. Like, I'll eat ketchup on quite a bit of things. Like, I'll eat it on like french fries. And actually, I don't know what else. There is quite a few other things I'll eat it on. But like, that it's good. I mean, I just don't know. I really have not met a person that does not like french fries. Like, I honestly, I've never seen a person that doesn't eat french fries, because the majority of restaurants do serve french fries, probably because a lot of people like french fries. It's just like a common food. It's like a common American food. I mean, some people don't like hamburgers. I understand that, because like, that's, I like hamburgers, but like, with the texture of the hamburger meat, it's kind of weird. Like, we have a few friends that don't like tacos and hamburgers and that kind of stuff, because I just don't like the texture of the hamburger. Which I completely understand, but like, I have never met someone that does not like french fries. My whole life, I've never seen someone that does not like fries. Like, I mean, a version of french fries, either like sweet potato fries or whatever kind of fries you want. But like, french fries are like a common staple to an American diet of being overweight, guys. Like, I'm not even kidding. It's a common staple. Like, literally, pretty much every single fast food restaurant has some type of potato fry. Like, KFC has it. They have their potato wedges. Like, I'm not even kidding. It seems like every single fast food place besides a pizza place, most likely and Subway, has, like, most fast food places do have some sort of potato meal. So technically, when you eat french fries, you're eating vegetables. So, I mean, guys, you're balling out there eating those french fries, packing on the poundage, getting huge, and it's great, guys. Like, french fries are a high staple to the American diet. Trust me, guys. They like will make they'll make you big and strong, just like the potatoes do. Just like your mashed potatoes and your sweet potatoes and your baked potatoes and your fried potatoes and your french fries, right, guys? French fries are awesome, and so is popcorn. Like, dude, that's the one thing I cannot like not eat. And when you go to movies, you can't not have popcorn. Like, that's one of those things where when you go to a movie, it's just like, it's almost a guarantee that you're gonna have popcorn. Like, you just can't not, because it's like, it's such a great great thing. It's like popcorn. It's just good. I mean, like from the movies, obviously it's awful, but still good. Like that's all that anyone cares about. I mean, like, and like, guys, it's not that hard. Dude. Like some movie theaters, it's easy to sneak stuff into too. Like it's not hard. But anyways, back to French fries. You guys better eat some French fries. I might go eat some French fries today. Like, after, when I'm done with all these videos, at, like, 6 o'clock shot. After I go to the gym, I might go eat some french fries. Because I'm just really in the mood for some freaking french fries right now. And I just wanted to rant to you guys about french fries, because french fries are good. And, like, they're good with, like, ketchup and ranch and whatever the heck else you eat them with. French fries are great. Again, it seems to me like french fries and hamburgers are literally the staple of every American's diet. Like, I mean, like, it's kind of what built America, except, I mean, besides the cars and the buildings and the roads and everything else. I mean, french fries and hamburgers, it seems like, really built. And, like, there! He's hit me with a pitch, guys. I know that's kind of off topic of the whole french fry thing, but it's like, let me charge the mound. There needs to be a charge the mound button so I can go beat some pitcher up, you know, because he can't be hitting me. He can't be doing that crap to me, to Tyron. To Big Daddy Clem, he can't be doing that. Only my dad can hit me. Only my daddy can hit me. Not, well, I'm Big Daddy, but only Big Daddy, only bigger daddy. Like, I mean, the pitcher can't be hitting me. Only Big Daddy or my mom, or you know, whoever is my daddy can hit me. Not the pitcher, because the pitcher's not my dad. He's, you know, guys, he's not your daddy, so the pitcher can't hit you. Anyways, so, you know, we're off running. There's, like, 2 outs left, guys, and I'm still thinking about french fries right now, because french fries just sound so bomb right now, guys. It's like, come on, like, tell me if there's one of you guys that don't like french fries, please tell me down in the comments below. I'd like to talk some sense into you, because I have literally never seen someone not like french fries. I am just so, like, I don't know, guys. I don't know, french fries sound really good right now. Tell me if you guys want some french fries. That'd be funny if you guys are watching this video while eating some french fries. That'd make this video 15 times better because, no! You know, the french fries would just be like french fries, right? They'd be like, well, I mean, they'd be french fries, but... You know, what kind of french fries? Tell me what kind of french fries you guys like better, like steak fries or the skinnier french fries. Like, I don't really care. I mean, they all pretty much taste the same to me. It's just like the bigger ones are more filling, and the smaller ones you can eat a little easier, but you can obviously eat more. Because they're smaller, but I mean, tell me which french fries you guys like better. I don't really care. It doesn't really matter to me. Like, I could eat either ones. I mean, if you guys have a preference, or if you guys like the waffle fries, like the ones at, oh, where is it? Chick-fil-A. If you guys like those better, or if you like sweet potato fries, because those are good too. I mean, like, really, those are good too. And, like, they're good with ketchup too. Like, I honestly, like, there's one of my family friends, he'll literally put ketchup on everything. Like, okay, he'll put ketchup on, like, tacos, guys. Tell me, he'll put ketchup on tacos or pizza. Isn't that kind of weird? Like, I don't know why he does that, but he just, like, I don't know. But back on the french fries, guys. Do you guys put salt and pepper on your french fries, or just salt? Because I usually put pepper and salt just because, you know, well, usually not salt, because half the time they have way too much. So, you know, you just put some pepper on there, because pepper, I put pepper on, like, nothing. I think it tastes better. But anyways, you know, french fries, those are pretty good, guys. But getting into this game, I don't know what else I'm going to talk about. I mean, I could talk about how I have a can that's worth 10 cents, actually, or this Gatorade bottle, or my headset, but I don't really know. Oh, guys, I wanted to tell you, too, if you guys, you know, like, if you don't want to buy a headset, like, this headset cost me $20, I just kind of dropped the bottle, this headset right here cost me $20, but you can use, like, I'm using the PlayStation camera for this face cam, you can use that for a mic, too, and then the mic audio comes out through your TV. So if you guys would rather have it where, like, you're sitting there and you'd rather their mic audio come to the TV and then everything you say, then you have to wear a mic. I use them both depending on if there's, like, other people in my room. I just use this, but if it's just me and I'm sitting down, I use that, and where I'm not playing any music, I'm using the mic. But it's like, you can really do either or. I mean, I'm just telling you, like, the PlayStation camera ended up costing me, like, $40, and the mic was, like, $20. But it's just it's one of the cheaper mics. So, I mean, you can honestly, like, it's just, if you guys want to be able to, like, talk and be able to hear that audio through your TV, you can do that. And, like, you don't have to wear a mic or anything. I just wanted to, so you guys know if you guys want. I'm pretty sure you can do that with the Kinect, too. I would doubt it. It'd be weird. That wouldn't make any sense. But, yeah, guys, you know, we're just been chilling, hanging out. We're playing the freaking Rubber Ducks again, guys. I don't know why you name a team the Rubber Ducks. Don't ask me, boys. I don't know. But, yeah, I don't know, guys. So, it's just been, like, I've been hanging out, and I really want to get a Logitech here. I'm playing with this freaking USB again. I really just, I don't know. It's like a fidget spinner, except it's a USB.
Into the windup, here like, comes the really. 0-1.
It just goes up and down the whole time. See, I don't understand how to use this Showtime thing. You guys are seeing me trying to use it multiple times. I think I use it on multiple of these pitches, and I don't know how to do it. It's like, I just don't know what I'm doing. I try, and it's like, okay. Like, there we foul. We were early on the pitch, but it's like, with that Showtime thing, I just don't know what I'm doing. It's like, I get really confused on how to do it. It just doesn't make sense to me. And, like, it's just, it's, I don't know, guys. I'm not very good. I just screwing up. And, guys, hey, if you guys play the show, I would like you guys to tell me if, how you guys, like, how many games it took you guys to get up from the AA into this, or into the next one, and then eventually the MLB. Like, how long it took you guys, if it took you more than one season. I'm just kind of curious. Because if I don't remember how long it took me in 16, but I'm just kind of curious if you guys played 17 and you started from the bottom and you started as your position this year, you started a new one, you didn't carry over from last year. If you guys could please tell me like how long it took you guys, that'd be great. And sorry, I made a really bad throw there. But, like, I mean, if that, like, that's if you guys didn't change the sliders or anything. I'm just curious how long it took you guys by just when you're starting out with a 55 overall. When you, if, like, how long it took you guys to get into the next league and eventually get to the MLB, if it took you guys more than one season, because we'll probably be playing a lot of these games, but I just wanted to, you know, make my guy, like, show you guys my guy from the bottom again, and just eventually, you know, by the time 18 will definitely be in the MLB, but I just want to get a lot of these games done, because I also want to have these videos for you guys, and I can talk to you guys about stuff too. It's more sit down and talk videos, because since it's not live, I mean, be better, but yeah, guys, you know, and also, I really do love basketball, like, honestly, where do you guys think Kyrie's gonna go? I mean, at this time, probably by the time some of you are watching this, Kyrie would probably already have been traded, or he's still in the Cavs. But honestly, I feel like the Spurs, and I don't know what the Spurs, he'd be good on the Spurs with Kawhi, but I just don't know what the Spurs have to give. You know, I mean, they don't have much, and then, like, I feel like Timberwolves would have to give up Andrew Wiggins. But, I mean, like, they had, like, imagine if the Wolves still had Kevin Love. I mean, if the Cavs had Andrew Wiggins. Like, if that trade never happened, and if Jimmy Butler went there. Imagine if eventually Kyrie still wanted to leave. Like, if the Cavs had Andrew Wiggins and Kevin Love was still on the Timberwolves. I mean, I don't know if that'd be any good, because then it'd be Jimmy Butler, Kevin Love, and maybe Kyrie if Kyrie goes there. Or Kyrie might go to the Heat, but I feel like he'd rather go to the Timberwolves or the Spurs. But it's like, if he goes out west, it's gonna completely screw up, like, the division. Like, then the Cavs and the, it's almost like then the Cavs and the Celtics and the Wizards have to team up. Because if LeBron goes to, like, say LeBron went to the west, that'd just be, it'd be stupid, because then the east, the west teams would kill the east in the finals. It'd be the Celtics or the Wizards probably that they'd play against, or maybe the Raptors. And it's like, if LeBron were to leave the Cavs, it'd be like, that's almost why I'm saying LeBron almost needs to go to the Celtics or the Wizards or the Raptors, because it's like, with, like, KD and everyone else being, having two All-Stars and stuff on a team, it's just, it's not going to make it enjoyable. Like, I just, I kind of, if LeBron leaves the East, it's not going to be fun. Because if Kyrie leaves too, if Kyrie's gone, it's just going to be, literally, there will be, like, four All-Stars on the East. It'll be LeBron, Isaiah Thomas, John Wall, Dwayne Wade, Kemba probably, Hassan Whiteside, and a few other people, DeMar DeRozan, Kyle Lowry, Gordon Hayward, there won't be that many. And all the, like, the stacked All-Stars will be in the West. Because since Paul George left, Jimmy Butler left, it's like, the West is so stacked now. It's like, I mean, it makes me feel kind of bad, because it's like, I'm hoping for a finals, but it's like, the semis in the West are going to be insane. The Western Conference semifinals will be insane. And the East aren't going to be as enjoyable, just because there's not as many good players. Like, I mean, because with, it's just, I don't know, it's upsetting. Like, I mean, I'm excited, it's just kind of, I don't know. I talked about this in a whole separate video, and now with Kyrie possibly leaving, I don't know. I can't do anything about it, and I mean, it's the players, whatever the players want to do. But if LeBron leaves the Cavs, it's going to be, I honestly feel like Cleveland is not going to be happy if he leaves. But I mean, I don't know. They can obviously do whatever they want, but it's just, I don't know how good that'd be for the league with the whole, like, like, say LeBron went to the Lakers. Like, I mean, it would just, the East wouldn't even be entertaining to watch. The only two decent, or there'd be, like, three decent teams, and the Cavs would still be decent. They had Kevin Love. The Cavs would be decent. The Heat, the Celtics, and the Wizards, and the Raptors. I mean, that's not that. They'd be decent. Compared to the teams in the West, they'd get destroyed. It's like, there's literally eight teams in the West with two plus All-Stars. You got the Rockets, the Thunder. You got the, you could say the Clippers, because they got Blake and DeAndre. You could say those three. Then you got the Warriors, obviously. You got the Trailblazers, because they got McCollum. And Damian Lillard. There's a few other. There's the Pelicans are decent. The Spurs are obviously decent. And the Timberwolves. I mean, I'm probably missing a few teams. It's like they'd be so good. Like, imagine if LeBron went to the Trailblazers. Or like if someone went, Damian Lillard and CJ McCollum would like LeBron. Like, I don't know if they'd be good, but it's like I don't want LeBron to leave. Like, if LeBron leaves, I'd rather him leave somewhere in the East, because it's gonna completely screw up the whole margin of like the teams. And guys, you know, I started talking about French fries, now we're talking about NBA tips. I know we're just completely like all over the place, but it's okay, because this is a 20-minute long episode, and I had to come up with something to talk about for 20 minutes, which has been kind of hard. So I'm just kind of bouncing all over the place. Whatever comes into my brain, guys. I know I gotta clean up my room too. I had a happen. It just happens throughout the day. You know, it just gets dirty. But you know, I just want to thank you guys too. We're almost at 500 subs again. My goal is 500 subsubscribers by the end of August 10th, which is about. It's like this 22nd right now. I think 24th. Actually, let me check. Once it will say not charge anymore. Yeah, it's the 24th today. So we have about, that'd be like 17 days-ish. So maybe we can hit it, guys, if we grind, if we're making some good content and stuff. I'd love to be able to hit it by August 10th. That's my goal, though, guys. So let's try to hit 500 subs by then. That's just what I'd like to do. So hopefully we can, that's one of my goals again, but we still got lots of time, guys. So, anyways, right now in this game, we're up 1-0 against the Rafikan Rubber Ducks. I don't know why you name a team Rubber Ducks. Don't ask me, guys. It's up to Akron. It's up to LeBron and the, you know, the Cavs, just kidding. And this one's but, see, I don't know what their AA team or what MLB team the Akron Ducks is for. Like, I know I'm for the Pirates, but it's like the colors don't match, so I don't really know, guys, so I'm not sure. But, like, with the whole, yeah, guys, I mean, like, I'm excited for the NFL, too. Like, hopefully that's good. But it's funny how, like, the NFL is one of the most popular sports in the country. In the U.S., and literally it's the one sport that hardly is played. Like, I mean, it's hardly there's the least amount of game time. Because it's majority of the play calling, it's more the coaches. And, like, that's the thing with the NFL. Like, you can't really do what the NBA is doing by creating super teams. Like, with the NFL and the MLB, it's, like, it's so much more of a team sport. Because with the NBA, obviously, you can have a small forward and point guard. Because it's just the way the game works. It's only five people. You can have two great all-stars and be the dominant. Unlike with football, you can have a great receiver and a great quarterback. Your line can be awful and your running back can be awful and you can lose. Just because it's a defensive sport, too. So it's like there's 33 people playing and like including special teams and stuff. And it's like, okay, there's so many more people to rely on, and you can have, like, Kelvin Johnson, he can be insane, and you can still lose. Because you can have one great player, but they can be on an awful team, and it's not going to matter. Just like, that's, like, the difference, like, with LeBron. He can make any team great, and I'm sure Steph and KD, and they could all make a team a playoff contender also. You put him on any team, you put him on the Kings, you put him on the 76ers. Wherever, I'm assuming they could make that team a playoff contender just because it's with basketball, it's more of an individual sport. It's also a team sport, but one person can change the role of a game completely. They can have an insane game, like when Devin Booker scored like 60 points or 70 points or how many ever he scored. It's like you can have one person completely take over a game. Obviously, in the NFL, that can happen with receivers and quarterbacks, but I mean, you need it's more than one person. You got the offensive line you got to worry about, you got the defense you got to play against, and it's just the defense has to be decent too. Otherwise, you can score as many points as you want in the NFL, but if your defense is trash, if your defensive players are trash, it's not going to matter, you know? I mean, with the NBA, you can be a great offensive player and just be awful at defense. Like, kind of like James Harden's not awful at defense, but I mean, he's sometimes criticized for not playing good defense, but I mean, he can still be decent. Like, you don't need to have that good of a defensive game. You could be an extremely good defensive player like Kawhi. He's not as good offensive. Him and KD are kind of backwards. KD is more offensive. Kawhi is more defensive. But I mean, I don't know, guys. We started talking about French fries, but, you know, I really do like French fries. I'm probably going to go get some French fries here soon, guys. Probably go to Steak and Shake. Hopefully Logan gets back before happy hour, because then you can get shakes for like half off, which is good. But you know, guys, we're wrapping this up here in the next minute. Hopefully it doesn't take too long, you know, because I'm getting kind of sick of talking, to be completely honest. Just kidding, I'm not. I could talk to you guys forever, but it's just hard for me to come up with consistent ideas when I'm doing these all in the span of like an hour. But yeah, guys, I really do like MLB The Show, definitely. See, like, this Showtime thing, I really don't understand. But guys, please comment chicken nugget, or no, comment French fry if you made it all the way into the end of the 19 minutes of this video. I doubt anyone did, honestly. But comment French fries down below if you got, or French fry, or French fries, or potatoes, or something dealing with French fries. If you guys made it this far into the video, please tell me, guys. But I'm pretty sure we ended up holding the L there. We ended up losing 4-1. We did not play good against the Rubber Ducks, guys. Anyways, guys, it's been Manimal King Clutch here. Hope you guys enjoyed this MLB The Show video. Anyways, guys, have a great yesterday. Peace out, guys. Thanks.